Fall Collective, welcome back to the Ascender Divination Priestess channel. I am sending you all lots of love, joy, peace, and happiness. Many, many blessings to you and your families. As always, I return to source, I return to sender. All negative energies and intent immediately and permanently, I call in only the purest of white light and pray that you stay only in the highest of vibrational energy. Whatever the enemy has stolen from you, it is returned to you. All evil and negative plans of your enemies against you are dismantled, being dismantled as we speak. As I have said, so shall it be. Okay? Judgment is final. So let's go ahead and get into our tarot reading. We have a Queen of Wands. We have a queen, not a queen of wands. Why did I say the queen of wands? Maybe she's up to something because she's been showing up a lot in the readings. Okay. We have a queen of pentacles that may be going through some type of mental adjustment, like some type of change. Maybe she sees you as someone that's genuine now. Maybe want to come towards you to give you some type of friendship. Maybe calling a truce or something. Someone is maybe having to move on or is being forced to move on or something because she's way down and burdened. I will not entertain this woman if I was you, because this is the person that's been gung-ho behind the scenes to take you down. If she's going through healing, that's a beautiful thing. We always want people to take the initiative to we want people to take the initiative to heal and master themselves. So I think this is what she's starting to do. Now, I don't know if this is the actual Queen of Pentacles in the reverse that we've been dealing with and been having a lot of downloads about. But whoever this woman is, she is moving forward in life, maybe making some type of new turn. Maybe she's coming out of a relationship that was not fulfilling, or maybe she's learning to balance things out in her home front and stop focusing on other people. This would be the woman that was in competition with you for a gentleman. And when I say gentleman, that's a very generous way of saying it, okay? But there has been a Queen of Pentacles out here in the spiritual communities. She's not part of the spiritual community, but for some reason, I don't know if she and someone were going through a separation, or she wanted to be someone's main choice, main woman, be the chosen one. I don't know what it is or what it was with this woman, but there is something where I don't know if she's going through a tower trying to minimize the effects of her actions that she's been taking against another person. So what she's trying to do is possibly come in and give you some type of friendship to mellow things out, but this is not someone I'm seeing that is completely healed. I think she's just wishing that she can come and give you some type of extended friendship or some type of olive branch to prevent a tower from taking place and to block you from receiving some type of Ace of Pentacles offer, because she's living in fear or some type of chapter ending in her life, which will have to do with her having some type of ultimate fulfillment. This could be someone that's been out here telling people that you were interfering with her relationship, had people looking at you real funny, telling a whole lot of lies and things like that, doing a lot of manipulations behind the scenes. But it's like, yeah, this is someone with ulterior motives, with a lot of dark ways. May have been trying to trap a masculine with her, trying to get him to see her as his wish fulfillment, as his equal, as someone that's very independent, but she's not really independent. So he may have left her out in the cold to take his commitment somewhere else, and it has her burden. This is someone going through some type of financial like, or this is where she's headed. So I think she believes that in order to minimize the effects of her actions, to minimize karma or whole of karma, because you know there are dark workers out here that are delusional enough to believe that if they take certain actions, have some type of ritual done, have some type of cleansing ritual done or whatever, that they can hold off karma for a specific amount of time. That is a delusion and an illusion. What you're meant to get is what you will always get. Okay, you put out what? You get what you put out into the atmosphere. So if you're putting out negative energy, you are going to get negative energy. The reason this woman is taking this action is because someone has been very dedicated extremely dedicated to blocking you from receiving some type of love offer. And the fact that she's finding out that regardless of what she's done, what she's gotten a group of people to do to you, which is slender, block, dismantle your foundation, or at least try to, was in some type of heavy competition with you. It looks like you are still moving forward. You are still giving a love offer or receiving a love offer. You are still moving on to calmer waters, sailing onto calmer waters. You are healing. Yeah, whatever it is you went through, it was very hard, but it looks like you're still moving on and choosing to heal so that you can have wish fulfillment, mastering yourself, balancing your life out, and still passionate about the things that matter to you in life. This was your intention for you, this woman, and everybody else behind the scenes. You yourself, you are a Queen of Pentacles, and this is possibly how someone is seeing you. There could have been some type of prophecy that has been fulfilled due to the actions these people were taking. So this is like you telling people, hey, don't do that. This is going to happen. And they look at you like a joke, or they take you to be a joke, only for the very thing you try to stop them from doing. For the very things you try to stop them from doing so that something else wouldn't happen taking place. So if you told them, hey, don't do that, someone is going to pass away. These are people that go to do rituals faithfully, go to practitioners, dark practitioners faithfully. If they don't have a dark practitioner available, they will go and manipulate a light worker into believing that they're the victim. And if you, as a light worker, you don't do your due diligence to read into these people, you make a mistake and help them block someone else's future, block someone's fulfillment, and then you're out here putting protection barriers around dark workers, baby, you don't end up on the wrong side of the spectrum. So there's something where it's that they've been doing a lot of rituals, something has been backfiring, someone may have passed away in a community. I remember, and I forgot to mention this on my channel, there was a reading that I did where I said someone had passed. So I had did a reading before and said someone was going to pass away if they did something. And apparently they still went and did it. And then it came out that someone had passed away after that. And I did the reading and said that someone had passed away. The very next day, what do I see passing down the building I live in? A fleet of cars, because there was a funeral going on. When I said they had the limo, you know, the limo they put the coffins in. Yeah. That and like a fleet of cars. It wasn't a lot of cars, maybe, like, I don't even want to estimate, but it was not a lot of cars, but they all had their lights on flashing, letting us know that there was a funeral going on. And then the police officer in the back on a motorcycle behind the last car. Baby, when I saw that, I said, oh, wow, well, something really has happened. So whatever has happened behind the scenes has this woman way down. But this is someone with some type of mental issue. So whatever it is that has happened, is she's still out here trying to cause some type of illusion. And I don't know what it is that's going to get this person to balance their mental out, but that's not our place to worry about, because she's still collaborating behind the scenes to do something. I don't know if a community is trying to see things from a higher perspective and balance something out, but a woman behind the scenes is still trying to force things to go her way. She's still out here lying, manipulating, possibly even out here pretending that she has, you know, gone on the straight and narrow, but she really hasn't. What it is she's doing is creating some type of collaboration or fathering some type of narrative so that she can receive some type of abundance that does not belong to her, because someone wants to be seen as independent. Someone wants things to go her way. There could be some type of divorce proceedings going on between she and someone else. So this could be like a wife character that was in a relationship with a masculine that was open to dating other people. Maybe these two were in some type of open relationship. I do see the Hierophant out here. This woman is burdened because this relationship is over. She's about to be out here single, lonely. I don't know what this is, honey. I don't even want to get too deep into it. But this woman is out here living in fear of two people coming together. This is absolutely a wife character. As you can see, she's going into what this court proceedings as a wife, and then she's coming out as a single woman. So there is absolutely some type of change going on. You are a Queen of Pentacles in your own right, because you're someone that's business savvy, a mother figure, very down to earth and things like that. And you are committed to improving your life, being, you know, scale and things like that. And you are working towards your independence, or you are someone that's very independent, very self-sufficient, self-reliant, not out here looking for a handout. But I want you to see the difference in what is taking place in the both of you's lives. She's going in as a wife, coming out as a single woman. You are going in as a Queen of Pentacles, mastering yourself, coming out as someone very abundant. Okay. And she's coming out single, but she is going to be okay in life. She will have enough to kind of maintain herself. That is, if she can mind her business, stay in her lane, and not be out here trying to defeat people, trying to trick people into taking paths and things like that, that does not have anything to do with them. Excuse me. This woman, there's something about like bullying. Like, this is a bully at the core. And the reason why this woman is a bully has to do with her childhood. This could be someone that's very clueless. 2 + 2 don't add up easily for her. This would be one of the women when they were kids growing up, mom is helping them with their homework. They say, Ashley, if Johnny has 2 apples and Peter gives him 6 more apples, how many apples does he have? And she'll say, 10. And mom is like, no, 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 Ashley. If Johnny has 2 apples, Peter gives him 6 more. How many does he have? And she'll come back and say, oh, 22 apples. And then mom has to woosah, collect herself, do her little breathing exercises, and then tell Ashley, you know what, honey, sweetheart, we're going to come back to this later, okay? Let's just take a little break. We'll come back to it, because mom is at a boiling point. Mom is like, the heck did she get 22 from? Where did she get 10 from? This will be one of those women. This will even be one of the women, even though they have a degree, they don't know nothing. You know, there are people in life that go to school. This is typical of all of us. And I'm not going to say some people, all of us, we go to school, what? We learn, we get our bachelor's degree, get our master's degree, and we come out, what? We don't know nothing about life. The only difference is some of us, we put in an effort to learn life. This one did not. So she may have some type of education, but it's not something that helps her with common sense. Someone can be book smart, which I'm not even getting, but she could be book smart, just not common sense, street smart, life smart, nothing. Just a bully. That's all. Just a bully. So there could have been some type of proceeding that's been taking place for a long time. Oh, yeah. She don't want to be a single woman. Oh, baby. She don't want to be a single woman. She's been trying to put off this divorce, been trying to prolong this divorce for a long time. And that man, whoever she's leaving, he said, I'm moving on. And it's causing her a lot of distress. A whole lot of distress. These will be one of the women in society that believe that because they're married, they're better than other women. She has a problem with single women, single mothers. Look at that. Baby, welcome to the club. It's fabulous. You just got to do the right thing. Be a good mother. Stay true to yourself. Yeah. Uh-huh. Welcome to the club. Welcome to the club. It's okay. It's okay. Glare girl, you can't flex your marriage no more. You can't flex no more. You can't be out here telling, but I'm married. I got a husband. She don't got no husband. Girl. Well, what's that, Ashley? What are you saying? Did you say you had a husband? No, you don't. Oh, welcome to the single mom, single ladies club. Oh, baby. You could be a light worker. This woman has been trying to destroy, and she's probably bothered behind the scenes because you know exactly what this woman is going through. Because this is someone that has made it her life mission this lifetime to destroy you. Oh, someone was on you. They were on you. They said, by all means, I'm trying to protect my relationship. I'm just trying to save my family. Meanwhile, the whole time, people didn't know they were in an open relationship. Never been happy. He had a whole side piece the whole time. Probably had her own thing the whole time. I see her giving a love offer to someone else. So she more than likely had her side piece too. But there's something about you this woman don't like. So she saw you. She said, he cannot be with that one. If he gets with that one, he's going to want to marry her. I won't have advantage over him anymore. Won't be able to use him anymore. She's going to take all his money. No, 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 no. Then everybody out here ain't a gold digger. She tried to probably manipulate a community or even a masculine about you and said that you were a gold digger. Only for them to find out you don't even know this woman or her husband. Never entertain her husband. But this came out before. It's coming out again. So the divorce is finally taking place. We I see the Three of Pentacles. A sister's about to go from being the wifey to the single ladies. Guess what came out? my ancestors got a sense of humor. All the single ladies. Now put your hands up. Except the person you've been laughing at for being a single lady, baby, guess what? They're about to be married because they're getting a commitment from someone else. Oh, the tables are turning, Ashley. What you gonna do? What you about to be saying out here? I used to be married. There was a time in my life when I used to be married. And someone's gonna look at you and say, used to, don't count no more. It's going to be Ashley, a bother, hovering around, trying to stalk people. She said, I got to find a way to end this relationship. Girl, you got to have to move on. Going to have to heal. All this lying and manipulation is not doing you no good. For whoever is in some type of divorce proceeding with Ashley, baby, I don't know why the name Ashley came up. Be careful. Ashley could be paying someone behind the scenes to make sure something goes in her favor so that she can come out on top. Okay? Because Ashley is out here trying to make sure you do not have any money. Okay? Any money? Any money to spend on your new BITCH. That's how she called her. That's how she sees her. She said, he ain't getting no money. He ain't about to be out here spending our money on that BITCH. Oh, I'd be damned if he does. So she's making sure it goes in her favor. You may want to get a new lawyer. You may want to ask for a new judge. Because, baby, it's something going on. She's thinking and plotting, trying to find a way to trap you and block you from moving on. But this separation is your justice. Just be cautious. She's up to something sneaky. Ashley is out here trying to have you snuck and trapped so that she can end your possibilities of moving on. But I think you're trying to still stay strong, stand your ground, and move on because you've made some type of decision to move on, take a new direction so that you can defeat whatever this is and have a relationship with someone else. Ashley says she's determined to make sure you don't go nowhere. She said, you either going to be with me in this open and unhappy relationship, open and unhappy marriage, or you ain't going nowhere at all. You know one of those crazy people that say, if I can't have you, nobody else will. That would be this one, but in a feminine energy. I'm telling you, Ashley's out here living single. Husband out here living single. What's the problem, Ashley? What's the problem? She said, no. No, you can't be a bachelor because when you are a bachelor and you go to that earth angel, you're going to get married. She said, he finds her to be beautiful. She is beautiful and she is young and vibrant. She is very loving and healing and she tells the truth and she's protected. I don't did a lot of witchcraft to block her. I don't invested a lot into. Ashley has invested a lot into blocking someone, blocking communications, causing a stalemate for as long as possible. She said that Queen of Cups, she cannot get that letter. She cannot get that information. So Ashley's been causing a lot of illusions, tampering with people's investments and resources. Says she don't want no king of whoever coming towards the Queen of Cups. Because if they come towards that Queen of Cups, it's game over for Ashley. Ashley, darling, you're in a divorce proceedings. You need to let this go. You need to let it go. The person you are trying to attack ain't paying you no mind. She is out here. He is out here. Whichever way your husband goes now. They're out here doing their work, minding their business. And here you are all up in their business and things like that. trying to smear characters and things like that, telling people that the person was flirting with your husband. He, she, them, they did not flirt with your husband, Ashley. Stop telling lies. Stop telling lies. Why are you so afraid for two people to come together? Is it because you know they're going to be victorious? This was a prophecy that came through. Baby, all the readings are just coming on through. Everything we've been predicting on this channel has been coming through. We told Ashley a whole long time ago, stop your lying. Stop the illusions. Mind your business. Okay, don't matter who that man want to give to, you too burden and worry about what it is he's doing out here. Now look at you, Ashley. Look at you. Look at you. Down and out. The whole community that you got together to come after someone, all down and out. The collaboration is over. The family is over. It's a toxic woman. This is the woman who you get in a relationship with them. The whole family feels like they own you. They can control you. You can't leave their daughter. Why? Because you got money. You got money. I don't know if he has like a business collaboration with them. This is someone that got married to a woman and he went in. Yeah, they got a business together. This is not just like a divorce. There's something about assets in this proceedings, this court proceedings, baby. This will be a very abundant couple that's been very miserable together for years. And they just kind of came up with an agreement. She will live her best life. He will live his best life. They will live in the same house. People will still feel like they're together, but they're not really together. He got his little concubine, but the main chick on the side, like he's living a fulfilled life. He got a concubine, but that's the main chick. That's where his heart really is. Okay. Like he be out here seeing his main chick. No, he can't, you know, be out there bull with it. So he just be watching his main chick just going back and forth like, ooh. That's how someone's been living for years. He said, I can't do it no more. You can do what you want, Ashley. They don't have some type of agreement about when they were going to separate and go their separate ways. The time has come for them to go their separate ways. For some of you, she don't want to let go. He don't want to let go. They still want to keep going. They want to drag something out. Baby, I don't know what this is, but when people want to go and be happy, let them go and be happy. You go and be happy too. You go and be happy too. Yes, baby. Go out. Go be happy. Live a fulfilling life. Okay? Because whoever he is, I think he's a King of Pentacles. He wants to go and be happy too. Leave him alone. You want to argue. He don't want to argue with you. You mad. He don't want to be mad with you. That man want to be happy. Go find you a little boo thing, a little a sugar baby or something. Be a sugar mama, cougar or something, whatever it is, honey. Be a cougar or something. Because I don't get like an ugly woman. I think you're a very beautiful woman from what I'm seeing. Go find you a little cute little thing and live your best life. I don't think that man is worried about you like that. Or is it because you want him to be worried about you? It's one of those women, you know, you two ain't happy together, haven't been happy together in a long time. And then you F around and find happiness out here. Now she don't want you to be happy. So she start doing things to get you to see her in a light that you will never see her. And she said, I need you to see me in a new way. I've changed. He said, nah, Ashley. Pretty young thing is waiting out here for me. Now you go and find your pretty young thing. Baby, I bet you some of these people be watching me be pissed off his head. Because they said, she don't take nothing serious. This is my life. She's talking, man, I'm just doing my job. I don't got time to be residing in negative energy. That's you all's business. I'm just doing my job. You're out here looking for a commitment from a man that you have been in an open relationship with for a long time. Long time. Maybe people didn't know it's been an open relationship. You've been out here giving love offers. He's been out here giving love offers. What's the problem? Is it because the new one is an earth angel? And they see right through ya? Listen, that other Queen of Pentacles you're bothered about, baby, they just focus on their work. They don't even know your husband. Never seen your husband, more than likely. If they have, it was probably a professional setting, because I see this 10 of Wands, 8 of Pentacles. They probably met in a professional setting, this institution. And it's never been anything more than that. It's a lot of Pentacles out here. So why are you out here bothered by another woman that ain't worried about you or your husband? This would be one of the women that should be wearing out their husband name. The term husband. My husband. My husband. My husband. My husband. Every 5 seconds. Husband. What you about to be? You're going to have to find you a new vocabulary. Husband. I had a friend like that before. Maybe she got married and every other sentence was her husband. Lo and behold, I found her husband in a car one day with another woman. I said, God dang, the husband, husband. What is she going to say? The husband is out here with a pretty young thing. I said, I ain't getting into it. That ain't my business. My name is missing and I ain't in it. So I left it just at that. Okay? I left it at that. Because this was one of those, like, if this was one of those insecure women, baby, she even thought she, he and I had something going. I said, honey. She was unsure. I said, girl, I don't play that way. She tried to accuse me of that stuff one too many times. I cut that friendship out real quick. I don't play like that. But, honey, I saw the husband sitting in his white car with a side piece, looking all happy, chillaxed. I said, don't I know you? He said, no, you don't know me. I said, you right. I don't know you. I said, you're right, brother. I don't know you. I went by my merry way. I said, they're going to figure it out. She know what she got into. She knows. She knows what she got into. But she sure stopped seeing her husband. After a while, she went from seeing her husband to Johnny. I said, God dang. Johnny's at work. I said, what happened to husband? Oh, baby, yes, this is a divorce proceeding. These two don't went in, came out bachelors and bachelorettes. This man said he want to go and be happy with his pretty young thing. Pretty young thing, repeat after me. Come here, bro. He saw that Michael Jackson out here. He said, I know you my twin flame, and I definitely been planning on coming to worship you to give to you. I know she's birding and stuff, and I'm birding, and you're going to reject me. But, baby, I want to have this new beginning with you so I can put an end to this cycle. I want to start something new with you. This is a whole pretty young thing that's a Queen of Swords. Dang, no wonder. More than likely, this pretty young thing said, I don't entertain married men. I don't entertain taking men. I don't entertain men with friends with benefits. I don't entertain none of that. You want to be with me? You're going to have to be single. Single. And she's out here living her fabulous life, single, not dating, but just living her life, being happy. And he said, listen, Ashley. I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to prolong this divorce. I can't be with my pretty young thing that can heal me. You know what? You know what? We're going to divide up these assets. You get 50, I get 50. Good? She said, no. I want 70. You bullshit. That's what you said. She said she want all of it because she's bitter. She's bitter. She said, I want all of it. I am getting all of it. He said, you're bullshit. You ain't getting it. That man said, you got me effed up in more ways than one. Nah. go back to the drawing board with your lawyer, come back with a different number, and we're going to talk. Because you know what? They've been together. He's the one that put in all the work to acquire this wealth. Not her. She's been living that good life. Don't got to do nothing. Her name is just on the business. No, 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 no. So he said he want to move on. She said, no, 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 no. She looked at the new pretty young thing. She saw herself. She saw the money they had. She said, he can't be with that one. So she went and got a community of people together, her family, to come after this pretty young thing. I want you to destroy her. Tell him she ain't his type. Tell him she's a ho, 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 ho. Tell him she is reckless. She's immature. She's disloyal. Everything. Oh, they went digging into this woman's background. Didn't find nothing legit. So they started telling lies. And it all backfired. Because guess what? Ashley is still coming out a bachelorette. Look at Ashley sitting there. Struggling to be content. God dang. She a whole bachelorette. He a whole bachelor now. Ashley used to be out here. My husband, my husband. Ashley saw that pretty young thing. Ashley said, no, not this one, not this one, not this one. I don't know if his mother is part of it, but maybe this woman got a whole institution. Maybe this whole family is going through it. They're going through it for coming after this innocent little pretty young thing. They said, No. Yeah, and him being single or maybe they're both single now. This is Ashley right here. Ashley's going to have to manage with what she can get. She thought she was going to take this man for everything. Talking about, I get 70% or I get everything. He said, you're bullshit. So he may have called her a B in his head. He probably said it out loud. Excuse my French. I got to say it. He said, you're bullshit, bitch. You got me. About it. She said, I'm going to take you for everything. He said, we'll see about that. We'll see about that. He said, hurry up. Let's get this over with. I want to go be with, girl, he want to go be with this earth angel. Why are you trying to hold that man up? He don't already made his decision and it's final. He ain't coming back. Girl, what's wrong with you? You want to argue. You under judgment. You thought everything you were doing would never come out. Girl, you lie to yourself. Look at you all trapped in your mind because this man don't went on. He's moving on with his life, balancing things out. Is that one of the situations she's watching a man go through some type of change? Like there's a man going through a change and he's trying to be the best version of himself for this earth angel, pitch of source energy. Because this is someone that's like a no-nonsense kind of person. It said, oh, yeah, I know I'm a healer, but I'm not about to put up with your nonsense. Like, if your wife was okay with you doing all of that, that's your wife. That's not me. You need to come here correct or stay over there. So, baby, she's about to be a woman of high honor, single. Okay, but she's going to be heartbroken, but she's out here trying to break this spiritual sword's heart. Trying to have this woman out here in distress, and the whole time the woman don't even know her. Girl, this is a whole prophecy. This is your karma you're going through. She don't know what to do. Ashley's out here confused. Don't feel sick. She said, Ashley's been so bothered. She don't develop mental illness. It's worse than what it used to be. Because she just know if these two come together, baby, it's a success. Oh, her husband could be a king of swords, king of pentacles kind of energy, baby. Yeah, Ashley, I don't know what to tell you, but this here is over. You're going to be burdened for a long time because this man, he's determined to get to this woman. You just gonna have to be out here mad. You thought you were gonna send a King of Cups in or something to do what? Nothing. You're gonna be mad. There's something worse that she's upset because this man has gotten in touch with his emotional side for someone else. And that's the thing. The people you are with, they bring different sides of you out. You're a Queen of Pentacles. Not the genuine one, but you know. You brought the King of Pentacles, King of Swords side out of him. So the person he's going towards is a healer. So that naturally is going to bring out that King of Cups energy out of him. Baby, I don't know what this is. If these two end up together, Ashley, you can kiss your husband goodbye. Because, I mean, he won't be your husband. I told you, you can kiss him goodbye because they're going to get married. God dang. You can kiss your husband goodbye because he ain't coming back. Oh, yeah, he's gone. You're going to be looking. Have you seen Johnny? Girl, Johnny's gone. Johnny's in a whole new relationship. They're having children and everything. They don't have two kids. The kids are real cute, real beautiful. Johnny's all happy now, healed and balanced. Johnny's out here living in the upright. Yeah, Johnny said he's giving a whole solid commitment, and it's causing a tower. I don't know what to tell you, Ashley, but your husband is your ex-spouse now. Oh, baby. Your husband. Your husband. Baby, you collective, you got a choice to make because you got two people coming towards you. You got a higher level soulmate and a twin flame coming towards you. Your twin flame, reckless. Reckless likes to have options. Oh, your twin flame likes to have options. Okay, in a whole Knight of Wands energy, he likes to have options. He want to have, baby, not just like multiple options. He may even be like into the alphabet community, LGBTQRSTUV. We're gonna take the S and the H out because he ain't that. But baby, your twin flame is out here living his best life. Oh, best life. Dun, 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 dun. Wand. W-A-N-D. I'm telling you. And he is committed. He's committed to that lifestyle. That man ain't finna change no time soon. When he changes, when will the roosters come home, baby? He ain't changing. So you may want to think, like, you should know. You know. You got a twin flame coming in and a higher level soulmate. You may want to go with the higher level soulmate. That twin flame stuff is overrated because a lot of the times, one of the twin flames ain't up to par. They're still out here having options, can't see clearly. But they still want to be communicating with you about how they see you as an empress, or they want to be with you, knowing very well they ain't ready yet to self-actualize and put an end to all the burdens that they come with so they can have a new beginning with you. No. Girl, go with the higher level soulmate. Okay, because your twin flame is going to have you out here looking crazy.
He's my twin flame. Why would he do this to me?
Girl, you knew that man liked options, having options. You knew. You better think before you choose between these two. Because, girl, one is going to put you in a karmic cycle, and the other one is going to give you true love. Okay? And he's working hard to get to you. He's working hard to balance his life out, be disciplined. One is healing behind the scenes, basically, and the other one is still living his best life. So you better thread with caution, because, baby, if you're done, you're about to be out here giving to someone that's available for the public. You got a twin flame and a higher level soulmate. I kid you not. So you're going to have to choose twin flame that's for the public or higher level soulmate that chose you. There's a difference. Okay? Your twin flame got a whole Queen of Wands out here that he sent after you to compete with you. And she was actually delusional enough to believe that she could defeat you. Okay? and you defeated her without even lifting a finger. That's the sad part. That's the sad part. She thought she was in a competition. Girl, how you gonna compete where you don't compare? He said, I bet you can't take her down. And then she got in her ego. I'm prettier than her. I'm the real high priestess. I'm the real empress. The moment you let that come out your mouth, it told that man, this clown here. She don't even know I'm getting entertainment out of this. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, trick. Ashley, girl, I don't know what to tell you, but your husband is your ex-spouse now. He's a bachelor. He's a whole bachelor out here trying to live in the upright. And we know y'all don't be happy when these men get out here and get their lives together. But they deserve it. You should be happy when a man get his life together to live and reside in his highest form. It don't gotta be for you. It's just good that he's doing it. That's that little girl stuff. When we're younger, we don't want the guy to heal for the next woman. It's not about you. It's about him, his soul. It's for the purpose of his soul. So I know you feel defeated. Whoever he's going to, he's changing for them. Assistance out here with options. Girl, you got options. Pick wisely, though. Pick wisely. Because if you pick the wrong one, you're going to be trapped in some type of love that ain't really love. You see this Ace of Cups followed by the Five of Swords? You're going to end up in a relationship with a narcissist. And I know I'm out here joking about her husband. Her husband may be a narcissist. So you need to thread with caution. He may just be trying to come towards you. Maybe this is not your higher level soulmate. He may just be coming towards you so that no one else can come towards you. You see, your higher level soulmate didn't even show up on here. And your twin flame is showing up in a Knight of Cups energy, Knight of Wands energy. So maybe this ain't the one for you. He's out here being a bachelor. So thread with caution. They're both single now. They went through the divorce. She's single. He's single. She was trying to drag that sucker out. He said, I'll take you for everything. He said, we can do 50-50, B. No, I'm going to take you for... Oh, you know when they're trying to take you for everything, that's that bitterness that's speaking. That's that bitterness that's coming out. He said, B, you got me effed up in more ways than one. I guarantee you, you ain't getting out of my stuff. She came out single. They said you can manage this amount, can't you? Yeah, okay, you can manage it. You don't got a choice. You're going to have to manage it. And he's out here living his good life. He's free at last. Yes, I am content. This court case is over. She was trying to get the judge to make things go in her favor, was trying to pay. I wouldn't be surprised if this woman paid someone behind the scenes before to make something go in her favor. And that man said, two and two ain't adding up. So there was a different judge over the case. And baby, she gonna have to manage with what she got. Because this is more than what you came in here with. This is more than what you contributed. So you gonna have to manage with this, okay? But anyways, they're having a meeting about you now. They said, how can we hinder this person from being seen? How can we block them and have them be left out? Honey, this woman and her friends, her family, they're still focused on you. Never mind that she no longer can see her husband. She's back. They're back to focusing on you. How can we cause distress to her finances? We need to end her. Have her put out in the street, burden her, temper with her work. And the whole time, pretty young thing ain't even bothered by these people, not worried. She's minding her business, doing her work, pushing forward. And these narcissists are still out here. Girls, I can't. I cannot. I cannot. My husband. If my ancestors were not so patient with me, Lord, I should have been going to H.E. double hockey stick a long time ago. If there was a place like that, it would have been at Cynthia. C Cynthia, you don't fell from you don't fell from grace. What have you done? my mouth is the reason I fell from grace. Must you laugh at everything? Ah, what else is there to do? Her husband. I see a woman that just thought she was better than other women because she had a husband. She didn't like women that were independent, self-sufficient, single parents. Didn't like any of that. But now she's that. You see how God works? God has a way of humbling people. They say everything she despised is what she is now. Got a budget, single woman, girl, no longer allowed to be in the club of my husband. Okay, you are being advised to take advantage of good advice. Oh, look at how I put that. It's a repetition for me. You are being advised to take advantage of wisdom from another person, someone that's wiser than you. It is not I. As you all can see, I was immature doing this whole reading. It is not I, okay? Because maybe her husband. Listen, find someone that's wiser than you. Maybe go to like a leader in your community or go find like a lawyer, psychiatrist, someone to talk to, because there's something that you need to talk to someone about before you make the wrong move, okay? Okay. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Stay blessed. I'll see you in my next read. Goodbye for now.